So I hope everyone doing very great. So in this video we are going to see about the dictionary in a Python. So until now I have covered all the data types, which is list, tuple, set and string. So you can also refer my old videos for these all data type. If you have any query, kindly let me know in the comment section, and please subscribe to my channel for daily videos. So after this video you are very familiar with all the data types in a Python, because I have covered almost all the details regarding all the data type in a detail. So you can do all the operations related to that particular data type. So in this video we will see regarding dictionary, what operation we can perform with dictionary and how we can mutate the dictionary, where we can use the dictionary, all the things we will see. So first question arises, what is dictionary? To represent a group of objects as a key value pair, we use dictionary. So in a dictionary, basically whenever we want to present any object as a key value pair, then we are going to use dictionary. What is key value pair? We will see with the help of example, then you will understand easily. Now the next thing is mutable. That mutable means we can change the value of dictionary. No duplicates in a dictionary, there is no duplicate values are allowed, and indexing and slicing is not allowed in dictionary. So now first we will see how we can create dictionary. We will see that empty dictionary and with the help of dictionary function. And while giving you the example, I will explain each of these words which I have told in the definition of the dictionary. Suppose I am creating one dictionary which is empty. So for creating dictionary we use curly braces. Now if we will check the type of A, so that will be dictionary. Now suppose I am doing like this, I am using dict function. Now if we are going to check the type of A, that will be dictionary. So that how we will create the dictionary. Now the next thing I am going to tell you regarding key value pair. Suppose I am creating one key like name and giving the value of name as Rajat and roll number. So here I have created one dictionary. If we want to access the value of name, so that is key. Name is a key, roll number is a key which having a value as Rajat and 1. So in dictionary always we present the values in the form of key value pair. So suppose I am going to access the name key, so we are just going to write like name, and we are going to use roll number, so we will just do like roll number and we will print yes. So that's how we access. And suppose I am creating the duplicate value and we will see like name. Now if we are going to print A, you will see this is taking the name as once because it did not allow the duplicate value. So all this thing is covered, that is mutable. We can change the value and we can, there is no duplicate value is allowed and it represents as a key value pair. And how we can access that element of dictionary, that I have shown you, like I am using the key and accessing the value of that key. So that's how we access the element of any dictionary. Now the next one we will see how we can update and delete this dictionary. So first we will see how we can update. And here what I am doing, A dot, where the key is name, I am taking like mastermind. So here the where the key is name, there we are updating as mastermind. Now if you will print the A, you will see name as a mastermind. So that's how we update the value of dictionary. And like this we can also add the value in a empty dictionary also. Suppose I can do like a dot home, and we can give the value like Kanpur. And now if you will print the a, so that new key will add in that dictionary, which is home. And so that's how we update the particular value, and we can change the value. That is the way. So now next one we will see the delete and clear in a dictionary, how we can delete and clear. So suppose let me print first a. As you can see here, we have dictionary like print a. So this is our dictionary. Suppose we want to delete del a. We want to delete the dictionary a. Now if we are going to print a, you can see a is not defined. So all the values in a dictionary is deleted now. Now we are going to create one dictionary like if you want to delete a dot the name. And now if you will print a, so you can see that key is deleted. So this is how we can delete any particular key value, and we can delete all the dictionary also with the help of del. Now the next one we will see clear. So suppose we have this dictionary also, this is roll number one, so we will use a dot clear. Now if we will print a, so now you can see what is difference between clear and delete. In delete, when we are going to delete the dictionary, it will delete all the dictionary, so it will not having any value, it will remove the object also. But in a clear, you can see after removing all the element, it have a empty dictionary. But in delete case, all the things will delete. But in that clear case, we will have a empty dictionary at the end. So I hope you understand this point. If you have any query, kindly let me know in the comment section. And one more thing about delete. Suppose we are deleting any key which is not present in a dictionary, then it will give us key error. Let me show you the example for this. Suppose I am creating one, and now if we are deleting a, and we are deleting here 3, which is not present in this dictionary, then it will give us key error. So that is basic this difference between delete and clear. Now we will see the some function in a dictionary in a detail. So first we will see the len. Len as a defined with the name only, it will help us to find the length of dictionary. So here you can see it having a 2 key, so it is showing as a 2. So this is the length of dictionary A. Next one we will see the get function. Get function is basically like, it is like this only, where we will pass the key and we will fetch the value of that key. So get is basically to fetch the value of any key. So suppose I have one dictionary like this, and we want to print the value of this key. So we will do like print a dot get, and here we will pass 1. It will give us the value of this. So this is same, we can also fetch the value of any key, just pass that key and you can get the value. Now the next one we will see about the pop function. So pop function is basically used to remove that particular key, and it will give us that value. Let me show you the example. Suppose I'm creating one, so if we are going to do like a dot pop, and here we are writing 1. So it will remove that key value pair, that is one, this one, and it will give us this value. Let me show you. So here it is giving A. Now if we are going to print A, you can see that is removed. So that is how pop works. Now next one is pop item function. Pop item is basically used, it will remove the random item, that we can also say that arbitrary item in a dictionary. So if we are going to use like print A dot pop items, so it will remove the random value. So you can see now this is, now the dictionary is two having value B. Now the next one is keys. Suppose I'm creating one dictionary here. So here what keys function do, it will return all the keys present in the dictionary. Yeah, so now the next one is items. So item, what it will do, it will give us all the value in the key value pair form, and these all the values are in tuple. So that is how items work. Now the next one we will see about the values function. So here I am creating one dictionary. So it is printing all the values associated with the key. So these all the functions are very clear with the name only, but just I am just giving the example, so there will be no confusion. Now the next one is copy, that is very clear with the name only. Copy, to make a clone of any dictionary we use copy. So now we will see that about the set default. So what that set default do, suppose we are going to print like a dot set default. So here suppose I'm doing 1, result. So if that key is present here, then it will print the value of that key. So now if you will print the A, but suppose this key is not present in that dictionary, so then what it will do, it will then add that key in the dictionary. Let me show you example first. So, Ram. So as you can see, 3 is not present in dictionary A. If you print the A dictionary, you can see this is added. So what that set default did, if that key is present, then it will print the value of that key. If that is not present, then it will add that key value in the dictionary. Now the last one is update function. Suppose I'm creating one more dictionary, like one, like so if you want to update A dot update B. Now if we will print, you can see all the values updated in the dictionary A. So I hope you understand each and everything about the dictionary. If you have any query, kindly let me know in the comment section, and please subscribe to my channel for daily videos and all the projects which I have created in my Python project playlist. You can check it out. And let me know if you have any confusion. Thank you so much guys for watching this video.